Hello, I'm back. I was looking at the face and I just wanted to add some yellow next to her nose. Let me bring a little bit closer. I did the yellow orange and I just go a little bit over the dark purple and just bring it down a little bit. Just like that. I think that adds a whole lot. Yes, that's better. I love it. Okay. I have my stamp. I have my red here. It's not totally dry, but dry enough. And I'm going to add some red in her hair. I'm starting here where not everything is covered. And I'm just making some strands of hair. And I blend a little bit. And I'm going up. I like that. I can see that in the screen that I like it. You can use any color you want. If you don't like this color, then maybe I'll add a little bit of pink too. I like that too very much. Just like that. And I'm starting up here and I'm going down just to make one string and blend that really well. Let me think. Where is my red? My white. Oh, here it is. For some highlights, you can add over the red or over the pink, just the white crayon. And let me see. Just a little curly, just a little bit of wave in her hair. This part I don't touch because naturally that would be the darkest part of her hair because that's in the back. So I won't touch that. Bring some highlights to it. Lovely. This way. On the other side, I do the same thing. Just one string of hair and I'm bringing it down. And then I bring a highlight in it up here. You can hear how hard I need to work to blend it. One more highlight here. I like that. It's not all black. I like it. Maybe just a little tiny, just like that. Yes. Okay. That is it for her hair. Now I'm going to take my stamp, and it is a very fun stamp. I really like that. And I'm going to stamp this. Let me see. I'm going first a test stamp. Yes. Yes, I'm going to stamp it. I'll bring you a little bit down. We need to make a necklace too, but first of all, I'm going to stamp it just here. Very soft. Let me see that. Really love that texture, and I like that really a lot. Where do I want? And then just some random stamps here and there. Maybe in some corners. This is a very lovely stamp. I'm going a little bit over her hair to that way we incorporate her a little bit. And I need my, let me see, I need my butterfly. Yes, she's, that butterfly is really gorgeous. And I did have that mistake here. You can see that. And I'm stamping right over it with a butterfly. And then my mistake is gone. I like it. Should I do something about the other side? Yes, I'm going to. Let me see. Put here too. Just like that. I like that. I really like that. Can you hear me thinking? Do I need to add some more or am I done? Let me see what I have. We are going to journal right here. I think we are done. Because otherwise it would be very, very much. I'm still unsure if I should color this piece in here. Here below. Or that I leave it this way. I'm really unsure about that. I think I let it be. Yeah, I think I let it be. Okay. I'm done stamping. I think I'm done stamping. Maybe I just maybe a little piece of, I often do this in her neck, some little dots. I like that. Just a few. And it's all to incorporate the girl with the background. And this is a really good way to do that. You can do it in her hair. Just like that. And maybe really a little bit up here. A little bit up here. Just like that. I love that. Really awesome. It takes a little bit of courage, but yes, 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 yes. Okay, now I'm done stamping. Let me think, what do I need to do more? My stamps away. I'm going to art journal. Yes, my dots are all dry. I'm going to art journal a little bit. I'm taking a black pen. I'm having a jelly wall. Sakura. And I love these. These write really on anything, really anything at all. I'm going to journal a little bit here, and I know some of you find it very difficult to journal about life, about difficult stuff, about a lot of things, and I think that's too bad. But if you have problems with it, if you don't know how to journal, or if you don't know how to journal, then just write down your I have a white spot here. I don't like that. Then just journal about this course. Journal what your process was, journal what your experience was, journal what you, if you like it or did not like it. You can journal about anything. It doesn't always need to be very heavy stuff or something like that. You can really journal about anything. So I'm going to write down that this is my first, although I make my own courses, but this is my first guest teacher's course. And of course, I'm really proud of that. So I'm going to journal about that. I'm, of course, setting the date. My date today is here in the middle of the night, really in the middle of the night. And that is what I'm going to write down. If you don't want other people to see what you write, then you could write a sentence and start back over that same sentence. Then really nobody can knows what you did write. Or you write from the left to the right, and then you turn your page and you start and go back that way. So I'm going to journal just a little bit. And don't be afraid of your own handwriting. I was that too at one point, but then I thought it is really my handwriting, so I embrace that at the moment, and I'm really proud of it. And I don't have a nice handwriting, but it still is my handwriting. It's really not that good visible. Maybe I need to buy myself a new Posca pen, because this one just does not work that good anymore. Today I had my first course video filmed. And maybe this is bad English, but to me it is good enough. It is my first time that I am a guest teacher and I am really excited. That's not okay. Excited and nervous. Now I'm done. And I like her. With love, I did make this video. Okay, that is how I do that. I just incorporate my my journaling. If you don't want to do that, then by all means don't do it. I'm going to doodle a little bit. I doodle really a lot on my faces and on the borders. I like dots. This is a Uniball Signal. It is inked. Ink? What's in it? And this one really writes write about on everything, and I really love this pen, pen marker. Do this by feeling. I make tiny, tiny little dots. I like that. Just like that. And maybe I make some tiny little dots here. And maybe some here. Let me see, am I in frame? Yes. And maybe I make some on the outer edge here. Just on the point of her strength of hair. Just like that. And I'm going to do a little bit on the border too. You can do all kind of doodling. I doodle often just, let me see, I have a big adding marker. These markers are awesome. They write about on anything, really anything. And I love to make this big dots, really big dots, just like that. My problem is if I start doodling, often I can't stop. I keep going and going and going, and I need to say to myself, Petra, this is enough. Now you need to stop doodling. It's really, really bad. But the effect is really, I like this. Look at it. I really like it. I really like it. I like it so much, I'm going to do it on this side too. I can't help it. I like busy pages. I don't know why. It's just what I like to do. It's just what I like to see. Although not long ago I did make a page and I really forced myself to let some white spaces in it. And I did manage that. And I really loved that page. I really loved it. I like it. But I don't do it all around. I guess I don't do that. No. So now I'm having my, I also have a white Sharpie and I have a white jelly roll. Now I'm going to make some very small dots just in between with my Sharpie. I hope you can see that. Let me see if I can bring it. Just some small dots. Randomly, there is no pattern, no nothing, just by feeling. I have no idea how long I'm filming right now. I can see that on my camera. The other side, dots are by far my most favorite doodle pattern there is. I really like making dots, it relaxes me. And the effect of dots are really big, I think. See where we are at the moment. I think I like that, although I think we need to do something, maybe just a small, little small row of white, tiny, tiny, tiny dots. Can you see that? No, you can't see that. Just really tiny little dots. They are really small. Can't I really can't wait to see what you guys are going to make, and what I hope you post it all in the Let's Face It group. It's a really exciting time for me, as it is my first time being a guest teacher, and that's exciting. I am excited about it. The English speaking is the hardest part for me, because my art, I'm just the way I am, and I like it to be playful, colorful. That is not the hardest part for me. The hardest part for me is my English. I'm really insecure about that, and I need to overcome that, and I will manage. I will be okay. I just need to practice a little bit. And sometimes I see a video back and then I think, oh, I should have said that, and that is the right word. And but because I'm really nervous about all of that, sometimes I just can't find the right word. But that's okay. Okay. These are really, 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 really tiny. I did them. I think we are done. We are definitely done. Or not. Or maybe should I do something more? There is that thingy again. Do I need to stop or do I go on? Do I need to stop or do I need to add more? I have no idea. Maybe if I do the larger one, then it looks like she is framed. Decisions. I don't want to think a whole lot long. If I look in my screen from the video camera, this really is awesome. So I think I do it. I'm going to make some larger dots too. I'm just going to do it. I'm just making the pattern. It will be okay. And you should do that too if you are insecure about it. Just do it. The only thing that can happen is that you don't like it, and that we have to, that you have to add some gesso or something, or black again or something like that. And that's really the only thing that can happen. And if that would happen to me right now, I would say it and show you, because you know we all make mistakes. Nobody is perfect. And we all make mistakes, also in art, and that's why I just sit down and just start the video without thinking, and just do as I always do, play and have a lot of fun in making art. So we will see if this is beautiful or not. And if not, then I'm still not be able to go to bed. And it is here, it is 2 in the night. And that's okay too. Let me see. I like it. I like it. I like it. I really like it. Yes, I like it. I like it, and I think we are ready. Or should I do the little ones in between here too? I could do just a few. just the little dots. On this side too. I turn my page around. Yes. Can't believe that I'm almost done.
I did it.
Okay. Oh. This is the page. I like it. I really like it. I just want to try one thing. Let me see. I'm not sure about that. I'm going to delete that too. I think I'm really satisfied with her. I really love the background. I love all my backgrounds, at least when I build them up like this. And the border, I really like the border. It's as if she is framed. I like the face. I like it all. This is it, guys. We are done. I'm very satisfied. I really had a great time. Really a great time. Thank you so much for being here, and I hope you liked my course and you like Let's Face It. I mean, it is really a fantastic course, and we all, even we teachers, can learn really a lot from it. And that's it, I'm done. I see you in my bonus video. If it is not already, I don't know if this video comes first or my bonus video. Well, that doesn't matter. I hope you did learn something from me, and I can't wait to see all your work in the group. And please keep posting. If you have any questions at all, you can PM me. Of course, we have a time difference, but that is okay. You can make a message in the Let's Face It group. There will always be some teacher there to help you if you can't wait. And that's it. Thank you very much, and I hope to see you soon in another course, in one of my own courses, in the bonus course, or it doesn't matter. Thank you very much. Bye bye.